TNTM The Show presents Indie Spotlight, Nittuku Anime Shop, with your host, Pablo Gunner, and guest,
Carlos Nicholas Reyes, aka Nick Reyes.
Gundam guru of El Paso, right?
Correct.
So, we're talking today because you have an anime shop, obviously. And so, that's located in El Paso.
Correct.
And so, it's actually, the location is 7595 North Loop Drive, Suite D in El Paso, Texas. 79915.
Correct.
And then if people want to give you a call for anything, they can call at 915-771-0020. And then your hours are usually 9 to 6, except for Sundays it's 2, right?
No, Monday through Friday it's 9 to 6 p.m.
Okay.
Saturdays is 9 to 2 and closed Sundays.
Okay, closed Sundays. All right, okay, cool. So, you know, you sell anime merchandise, Gundam model kits, you know, authentic and licensed products. But first, I wanted to start by saying, by just talking about anime. So, how did you get into anime?
No, I was like, back then, when tsunami hit, when, you remember the tsunami era?
Right.
What I grew up with was the Tom era. You remember when Tom used to do the little host by Steve Bloom and all that?
Okay.
I started off watching Rurouni Kenshin, Outlaw Star, Big O, and then, you know, I moved up from there. I would get back from, you know, elementary school. I get back at, you know, 2:30 back, and I get wait till 4:30 or when the block of tsunami would start in. That's how I started, and then I got off it when I got really into it, it was in my mid-20s when I was 21.
Okay.
My buddy Joseph Torres got me into it. There was a shop back then where we used to rent movies called Major Players.
Uh-huh.
They had a huge selection of anime, and then they had 99 cents for 5 nights, a whole box set, and that's pretty much where I started watching and getting back into the group. There were times I would try finding the box set, but sometimes they were missing a volume. But hey, I would, you know, after, you know, internet came by, you know, the new age of streaming, that's when I'm starting to get back into it.
Okay, cool. Awesome. Right on. So what would you say, like, you're the most into now?
I haven't seen anime for quite a while, but, you know, I'm more familiar with the older stuff, like, you know, the Tom run from Tsunami, the Tom era from the 2000s.
Right.
From Outlaw Star and all that, and, you know, Cowboy Bebop, Samurai Champloo, what else did I get into? Gundam Seed, the old Gundam. I haven't seen it yet, but I'm starting to get back into it. I'm watching it on, you know, on my streaming devices, whatever I can get, and I watch them on there. I think I seen the Gundam movie, you know, where they condense, you know how the anime shows, they condense them into a whole movie?
Right.
And they put them into parts?
Uh-huh.
That's where I watch them. And I see the movies, and that's all right. Every night I get back from work, home, I turn on my TV in my room. I turn on, you know, I put my streaming device on. I say, what am I going to watch today on anime? I put it on and, you know, I fall asleep watching like a Gundam movie or an anime OVA, and sometimes I watch a season.
Okay, cool.
And I fall asleep.
Awesome. So you sell a lot of Gundam kits, right? Like that seems like it's a big, that's the big seller at your shop, right?
Yes, our main company is Gunpla related items. We sell mostly Gundam and you know, well, we try to blend in, but we're mostly focusing on Gundam, but we mostly try to focus on anime.
Uh-huh.
Like little keychains, the stickers, the decals, the sticker sheets, the wall scrolls, the lanyards, the figures, and we're trying to get back into getting little candy toys from Bandai. You know, the little trinkets they sell, the little box.
Uh-huh.
Like the Assault Kingdom, the Sailor Moon Gashpong, the ones in the box. We're also getting the... You know, we're trying to get all that stuff in, you know, to diversify the shop.
For sure. So, how long have you had the shop?
All right, my dad started in... It's basically, my dad started as an Allstate agent, and then we moved up to... He did... he sells insurance here also, and we used to do payment agency and, you know, notaries and all that, and he does all the... You know, my dad has all the accounting, all that. I just do the volunteer work, do all the grunt work for him, and basically that, and I help him, you know, help him out, and it's kind of like, you familiar with on-the-job training?
Yeah.
That's basically what I'm getting OJT here, and learning, like, if you ever seen the episode with Samurai Champloo, remember the Mohushi Miyamoto?
Uh-huh.
The Johnny. They're the same, my dad taught me. Give a man a fish, he'll eat for a day. You teach a man the fish and he'll eat for a lifetime. So that's what he's trying to teach me.
Okay, awesome. Cool. Why were you inspired to start this shop?
I want to help people out that can barely afford to get anime. Because here in El Paso, it's expensive. It's like an expensive hobby.
Uh-huh.
And then I said, maybe I should get some look around. I researched, like, distributors and all that. I called up Japan. Apparently Japan's hard to ship out product.
Okay.
That's what saves you the freight. And what we learned, we go to America and they ship out right away and you get it right away. And, you know, we sell it at for like, you know, a little keychain will be $6. You go around here, they'll sell for $25 and up, or a wall scroll, they'll mark up the price. But us, we stick to MSRP and, you know, I want to help people. And no, it's just like, I just like doing it as a side job. It's fun, and I just, you know, just like, I have my good days and bad days, but, you know, I love putting that smile on that customer's face. They come in, they talk anime with me, and either way, you end up being friends with the customers. They turn out being your best friends.
That's fantastic. Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, that's really great. So, have you been to any local conventions?
When I was young, I used to go to EPAC, LCAD, and all that. But after a while, you know, I started seeing how the anime con scene is in our town. I just don't want to say bad about them, but, you know, it's like, I feel, like, embarrassed about them, how they work here in El Paso, so... What I just did, I quit going to cons here in El Paso when we used to do the local cons back then, so.
Uh-huh.
I just don't like doing them. I like staying away from the politics here, and, you know, we don't bother them, they don't bother us, but when they approach us, hey, our philosophy is we do a contract right with a con, right, when we go to a show.
Uh-huh.
We want to see the paperwork, right, and we want to, like, hey, like, see if they're going to do it within time.
Right.
They started like 2 weeks before before they're going to hit, right? They're going to launch it, right? And it says, hey, 2 weeks isn't time. We need to do orders and all that to have it. And we call in, and when they don't, sometimes they don't have numbers, call you, and then you got to be in a kind of like an inner circle, like kind of thing here in El Paso. You got to be in their inner group and all that, friends. You know how the Stonecutters works in The Simpsons? You gotta be a friend of a Stonecutter or save a life of a Stonecutter.
Right.
Pretty much that.
Okay.
And then when we go in, it's just like too many headaches. That's why I don't do cons in El Paso. I like joining going to the ones over there in Mr. Fennell's con and Sabaku-Con.
Okay, yeah, for sure. So you went to Sabaku-Con this year?
Of course. I went also last year. I was dressed as the second Noctis.
Okay.
I don't know. There was another one there dressed as Noctis with glasses and all that.
So how did you enjoy it? How'd you like the con?
I saw, like, when I went there, I saw something different than, like, the cons here in El Paso are organized. I saw, like, it was just, like, all, everybody was getting along, nothing was overpriced on the merchandise, everything was at MSRP, affordable, like, basically what I have it at, and, you know, it's like, I love giving my cards out there, meeting, how do you say, meet people, you know the Japanese way where you exchange a card?
Uh-huh.
You give them the card and you end up meeting those people. They come back.
Right.
Out of all those people, I know that thing is out of date, but you give them the card, you present them, they exchange it with you. You know, it's kind of like a business thing. You know what I mean?
Yeah, like networking. Did you have a booth at the convention?
No, I didn't have a booth, but I was attending. Okay. I went there.
So will you be doing a booth at that convention next year or any other conventions?
We can't say the least, but maybe if we ever close down, we will start doing booths over there on the out-of-town cons. Depends on the traveling fees and all that, but we're thinking about it, me and my dad, because one of the vendors inspired me to do it with my dad.
Uh-huh.
Mr. Jim Brazell, I saw him. He didn't speak to him on the first year of Sabaku 17. But then I spoke to him more on Sabaku 18. He told me the retired, he's retired, he's 68, and he's been running Pack Rock Collectibles for over 40 years.
Right.
And he also did a show in El Paso called Border City Comic Con.
Okay.
And we went there and I met him, I spoke to him, and he told me you should do that with your dad. You and your father should do that.
Yeah, because you said that he does that with his wife, right? He goes all over the country.
Yes, Mr. Brazell, he's a good guy.
So yeah, that would be really cool to just kind of travel the country by way of conventions.
Yeah, well, if anything ever happens, but you always have to have a backup plan.
Right, right. So what could we do to help out the shop and stuff?
Try to network on the TNTMT.
Okay.
TNMT. Try to send you some flyers and all that and boom, you know, blow them all over on the groups and whatever and just, you know, send them out and all messages and stuff through Messenger and we'll go from there and also, you know, share the show on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, the blog, whatever podcast we can get, YouTube. You know, blow it all up, share it wherever. That's what I learned my thing through marketing.
Okay, cool. And so, like, for what's like a regular day for you look like?
All right, regular day for me. This was you mean a work day, right?
Yeah.
We work out. We get up, me and my dad and my mom. My mom apparently has another job.
Uh-huh.
But my mom and dad, they wake up, they have their coffee. I wake up, drink my medicines because I have Asperger and autism, ADHD, and, you know, depression since I can't sleep at night. So a regular day would be this. I wake up, drink my medicine, get ready, put my stuff in our, just a note, we have a cargo van.
Uh-huh.
Our Nittuku Anime Shop cargo van. And also with my dad's business logos on there. We have I just call it the Millennium Falcon.
Nice.
And we just have a little JBL stereos and radio in there, and my dad listens to music. Sometimes I put mine on. And we just, our regular day would be this. My dad wakes up in the morning. He drinks his coffee with my mom. Or when he can't, talks with my mom, chats with her. And I get ready and all that. And, you know, my dad would sometimes go to McDonald's for iced coffee, but we don't do that much. But, you know, also a senior cup, 50 cent senior's coffee. And but also, we would get to work. My dad would leave me at the rec center. I work out.
Okay.
Cool. To keep my weight intact. And I work out for 30 to 30 minutes on the treadmill. And then I walk back to the office since the rec center is down the corner.
Right on.
From the skate park. And I would walk back and I open the shop, I get on my laptop, and I start, you know, basically I work. on there. I do basically orders with my distributors, and then basically, you know, sometimes when it's slow, I would have free time. I go on YouTube, research products on the Gundam, and you know how they do reviews on merchandise.
Uh huh.
I would look at people's reviews.
Okay.
And study all the products on Gundam and all the figures and all that.
Okay, nice.
I was also a teaching tool there. And, you know, I would also do my, you know, I do my other tech work on the site. And also what I do, I just, you know, when I get something, you know, I do it in my office. And then when I wait, what else? I get here, it's like, that's basically on our slow days, just chill out and when it's slow, basically. But, right. You know, when I have a customer, I help them, I talk to them, ask them, hey, what kind of anime do you like? Is there any series you like where I can help you choose an item? And I choose their item, and then I enter it on the square and enter the amount and ask, will it be cash or charge? And when they say charge, I enter the card number on the square and, you know, like a checkout deal and check them out. And also, when we get our shipments, I would email the invoices to our distributor of our merchandise. Also, we do it online ordering, and we would order it, and then when the shipment arrives 2 days later, FedEx leaves it on the door. I unpack it, I price everything, and post it all on Facebook. Hey, Gundams are here, and all the anime trinkets are here, and you know, play the waiting game for the customer to come in.
Okay.
And we pretty much wait for it.
All right, cool. So, besides like the Gundam, what kind of other stuff do you have?
Wall scrolls.
Okay.
Little trinkets like stickers, sticker sheets, magnets. Once in a blue moon, I order plushies, but that's a rare occasion. Sometimes I order figures, but, you know, rare occasion. Wall scrolls, keychains, cell straps, lanyards. You know, like, affordable things from $5 to $10 to $20.
Okay, so, but can someone just come in, and if there's something they want, they can order it through you?
Yes, that's also we do. If we can't get it with our distributor, we go through through another source, but you know, it costs a little more, but you know, getting the convenience out there. But also, we ask them, we don't have it, we'll piggyback it on our next order.
Okay,
but
cool.
Basically, like, get all the stuff they want, we write it down, we call that customer, boom. They want all the, you know, all the merchandise. Let's say they want a certain from a certain series, I look it up, I put it on the next restock list.
All right, awesome. Do you guys have a website?
No website. We use Facebook and Instagram.
Okay.
And you've been our mainly target.
And you can go to squareup.com/market/Nittuku Anime Shop, right?
Yeah, but we I haven't updated that. But you can use what you can do through. They message me there, and then I send them their invoices.
Okay.
Through you know, through Square, and then they come pick it up. It's only pickups only on the store, local, you know, like only pickups. We don't ship out.
Right, okay.
You learn that the hard way.
So all the stuff on there, that's what you got in the shop?
Yep. And sometimes the stock dwindles at times, so it's due to a high demand.
Okay, cool. And so you help people build their kits and stuff?
Yes, I help them what I do is I get them started. Like, I show them how to build them and all that.
Okay.
I give them, like, orientation, what are you going to need for a kit?
Okay.
What are you going to need for it, right? I would like you to, and that's how it goes on there. Let's say they need dippers, right? We show them a hobby set from Mr. Hobby Bandai. Just like Creole, we sell them that comes with a nipper, the tweezers, the X-Acto knife, and all that stuff for $30. And then we tell them what they need, and you know, and all right, you're gonna need the panel line to Gundam. You're gonna need a Gundam marker or Tamiya accent color. And we get them that, and kind of like all that stuff adds up.
So do you have to paint them and stuff like that, or they come like pre-colored?
No. They're all pre-colored, the Gundams. There's not fit, no paint or glue required pre-colored unless you're an advanced technique. You have to, you wanna like, you wanna paint them with, if you wanna take out the seam lines, use plastic cement. That's where you don't want seam lines on your kit.
Okay.
And use sandpaper to take out the excess glue. Or, if you wanna get the, you know, like the, you know, like the, way I do nothing but straight builds. That's all I can say.
Okay.
But basically, I teach the people how to build them, and I tell them which paints to use. I usually use spray can, but there's some people that use an airbrush.
All right, cool. And so a lot of the people that come in, you said like you've talked to them and you're buddies with them and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. Yep. A lot of them that come in are regulars, I become friends, I hang out with, we go to the movies, and I went to Sabakucon with two of them.
Uh-huh.
And other ones, we play also a game on, usually we play Skirmish.
Okay.
It's like a dice, ever heard of Warhammer?
Yes.
Yeah, you gotta download your stats on a... some website for, you know, Gundam, right? You gotta, but the thing is, you gotta buy the kit.
Okay.
To build your army, your unit.
Uh-huh.
And basically, you wanna use AU, get all that unit, or the Universal Sentry, or you wanna use, basically the, you know, like, the Federation or the Zeon, and you build your army, right? You get them, you build your kits, and then you play with them when you buy six-sided dice and roll them. We usually play at Military Game Supply.
Okay.
It's a gaming store. Because you know how they have the fields for Warhammer, the diorama?
Yeah.
We use those as cover.
Okay. Cool.
Mm-hmm.
So do you guys have any, do you have any DBZ stuff?
Oh, yes. We have, Wall Scroll, and we have also, the Little Keychains by DBZ Super.
Okay, cool.
And we also have, what else do we have? The little stickers and decals. Not stickers, stickers, and what are the other things called? Sticker sheets, puffy sticker sheets, and we have, what else do we have in DBZ? Lanyards, and we have, what else do we have right now in stock? We have, patches. That's what I forgot to mention. We sell patches.
Okay, cool. Right on. Yeah, it doesn't seem like there's really too many, like, DBZ build kits out there.
We do carry those too.
Okay.
Only on special requests.
Uh-huh.
But we add them in a restock. We always order DBZ kits too.
Okay, cool, cool. What do they have?
The DBZ kits?
Yeah.
They have articulation. There's two types. The figureized is going to be the 1/144 scale.
Uh-huh.
You build them, they're snap fit, you get the, they have the eyes of the Super Saiyan, and then you just snap them and build them together.
Okay, cool. And so they have all the characters?
They don't have all of them, but they need to make Yamcha, the... how do you say them? They have basically the main characters, like Broly, Piccolo, the Frieza, Super Goku. They need to make Beerus. I know that.
Yeah, that one's newer. They have Vegeta.
They have Vegeta, the Super Saiyan God, and Super Saiyan Vegeta. I ordered a kit the other day for a person.
Oh, sweet. Special That's order. Awesome.
We ordered them, Super Saiyan, God Vegeta.
Uh-huh. Okay, sweet. That's awesome. Cool, cool, cool. Right on. So, yeah, because I was always, like, hardcore into DBZ, and
yeah,
I like to...
I noticed when I saw you on the Sabakucon show.
Yeah.
On YouTube, you were, the Batman Vegeta.
Yeah. I like the new Dragon Ball Super as well.
Dude, it has its moments.
Yeah.
It is funny. It has its... you know, like its moments. But at this moment, it has its comedy moments.
Yeah. Same. Like it's weird though, because like sometimes the animation is amazing, and sometimes it's kind of weak.
Akira Toriyama was way ahead of his time on the animation. If you look at the eyes on the thing, it was way ahead of its time. Even though it was the 80s anime. DBZ was way ahead of its time.
Yeah, it's pretty sweet. The ambassador, he used to be part of the crew, and so he actually got me into Gundam. He shared his Gundam with me, and so I got into Gundam. I not like hardcore, but I watched it and stuff. So, but yeah, that intro song is pretty wicked. for the original. It's very catchy.
For the Gundam or the DBZ?
Yeah, for Gundam.
Oh, the original 1979, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was an... You know, also Gundam... You know, I grew up watching all the old stuff on Toonami. Like, up to the... Basically, Alva Star, Super Roni Ketchup, I haven't finished the series yet, but... The only thing that got me into TM Revolution... I don't know if you're familiar with that band.
I don't think so.
The one that sings Heart of the Sword.
Okay.
Remember the Roroni Kenshin, the third ending?
Uh-huh.
The it would come out on Toonami, the third ending.
Right.
And it was called Heart of the Sword by TM Revolution, and then he did the Gundam Seed opening and the Gundam Seed Destiny.
Okay.
And he did the Soul Eater opening. And he did the Sengoku Basara, Jap, and he did also, I don't know, TMR has done a lot of, you know, openings for TV show, anime. And he also has his own band, A Bridge in Boys Schools, as a side project.
Okay, cool.
And that's one of my bucket list to go see him live.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Are there a Japanese band?
TM Revolution. They're a Japanese pop group. Back in the... It started back in the early 90s. If you know the Hot Limits band, that's how you're going to know TMR.
Okay, and they're still playing?
Yeah, they've been around forever.
But they probably don't do too many tours in the US, do they?
They did Anime Expo in 2011.
Oh, no
and
way.
They also did... Remember this year's... I think it was this year's or last year. No, it was this year's. Remember the... He took his time for his schedule to go to the, you know, the Cherry Blossom Fest they have in Washington, D.C.?
Okay.
It's like a Japanese festival in D.C. They have a Cherry Blossom.
Okay, cool.
He did that concert there.
Right on. So, have you or you plan on going to a con in, the one in Amarillo?
Amarillo, Depends. If I got my friends want to go, where's that? Amarillo?
Yeah.
What's the name of the con there?
I think it's... I want to say it's Yellow Comic-Con or something like that. Yellow City.
Yoma.
Something
Yellow
like that.
City Comic-Con.
Yeah.
When is that?
I'm not sure when it is. I have to look it up myself.
Nah, probably if I go... thinking of going to AX this year, but... You know, we had the personal reasons. We had to, like, postpone it till next year.
Yeah.
And so we're going probably next year.
Okay, cool.
Or I'm going to have my dad nag him to take me to Sabotincon.
Okay, cool. All right, awesome. Cool. So the best way to just check you guys out, if we don't live in the area, is Facebook, right?
Mm-hmm. Or message me through there.
Okay, cool. Right on. So, if you're listening, go to get on Facebook, give them a like for Nittuku Anime Shop. That's two T's, right? Nittuku Anime Shop. Look that up and go give them a like and stuff like that. And then if you're ever in El Paso, give them a visit. You know, stop by the shop and buy something, right? Like a keychain or a notebook or whatever, right?
Or a binder or anything, or come by and chat with me, man.
Yeah, just go BS and have a chat with you and stuff like that. That would be cool. So make sure you go check them out. Like I said, they're at 7595 North Loop Drive, Suite D, El Paso, Texas, 79915. Or you could give them a call if there's anything you wanted to order you need help with at 915-771-0020. And then, like I said, there's also the website for thesquareup.com/market/Nittuku-anime-shop. As said before, right, the most of your hours are what, 9 a.m. to 6 a.m., right?
Yeah, Monday to Friday.
All right, cool.
It's the best day when I'm there. I usually take the day off on Saturday.
All right, cool, right on. Awesome, fantastic. So, thank you very much, senor. And we'll talk to you.
Thank you, Mr. Gunner.
Again sometime.
Pleasure talking to you. On TN.
Talk Nerdy to Me Network. Thank you for listening.